Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'll show you a science fiction horror film, Pulse. Spoiler ahead, watch out and take care. The movie kicks off with the programmer tensely walking through a crowded college campus. He cautiously looks around, as if trying to avoid someone or something. As he is about to enter a building, a bike side mirror shows a mysterious figure of a pale bald man. He stops, and the figure fades out as he looks back. He proceeds and drops off his valuables in a tray at the building security. Next, his information appears on the screen, but the indifferent security guard doesn't even bother to check. The programmer goes ahead and picks up his valuables. Then he spots a silhouette of a man standing still at the door from the CCTV's live feed. He looks back, and just like the incident earlier, the figure vanishes into thin air. Thinking that he might be seeing things, he ignores it and continues his way to the elevator, where he is joined by an old man. After the elevator door opens, the old man goes out first, and the programmer follows. As he walks through the dim-lit library, he nervously glances from side to side as he passes every aisle. He calls out for the hacker he was supposed to meet there. No response whatsoever, so he continues to anxiously look around the dark library and calls out for the hacker a second time. Still, there is no answer. As the programmer turns around, he stumbles on the same old man he met at the elevator earlier. The programmer picks up the books that fell and tries to return them, but the old man is already walking away while pushing a rusty book cart. He carries on looking for the hacker and secures the USB he has on hand. Suddenly, the overhead light flickers, and he spots the book cart moving without the old man in sight. Books fall from the aisle one after another, and he cautiously checks it out, thinking that it might be the hacker. He looks at the dark empty space between the bookshelves, and without warning, a screaming face appears. He jerks back and trips on the book cart. With his face on the floor, a horrifying humanoid with freakishly long fingers grabs the programmer's face and yanks his head sideways. The pale fiend then literally sucks the soul out of the programmer, as he screams at the top of his lungs. At a packed bar, the girl blonde navigates her way to where her friends are. She sits between the girl Curly and the guy Explode Hair. Sitting on the other side of Explode Hair is the boy named Eyebrow. The four friends are hanging out and having a good time, when all of a sudden, Blonde's phone vibrates. It's her mom calling. She ignores it and shares to Curly that she thought it was her on-and-off boyfriend, the programmer. Curly advises Blonde to move on and give up on her hormone ship with the programmer. Besides, they've spent more time away from each other than being together. Then, Explode Hair asks everybody if they're ready to dance. Blonde declines and leaves first. As she walks through the dark streets, Eyebrow catches up and surprises her. Eyebrow is clearly attracted to Blonde and offers to walk her home. She politely turns down Eyebrow and hugs him goodnight. She arrives at the apartment, takes off her jacket, plays the phone voicemail, grabs a cold pizza from the fridge, and munches it down. Afterward, a short voicemail from the programmer plays. There isn't much context. He just calls in, then hangs up right away, like making the phone call was a mistake. Blonde tries calling the programmer back, but it routes to voicemail. Unable to sleep, she gets up from bed and checks on her housemate, Curly. She isn't in her room, but is sleeping with a random guy for some random hormones. She then wakes up from Blonde's text message, stating to get her butt home. As Curly wears her pants, she accidentally hits the lucky guy's computer and sees her Cupid's arrow dating profile. Without hesitation, she deletes it. The next day, Blonde wakes up from the buzzer alarm. She gets dressed, prepares coffee, and wakes Curly. It's a typical day at the campus. People do their own thing while others are walking to class. Later, Blonde goes to visit her boyfriend's apartment. She sees a computer code running and takes a closer look. Afterward, she looks around the messy apartment, hoping to see her estranged lover. The programmer suddenly appears. His eyes are deep, relatively empty, and emotionless. He gently greets Blonde, then walks towards the computer cable and grabs at LAN cable. Blonde can clearly see that something's about to go wrong when he asks her to stay put as he enters a room. She hears a commotion and checks it out. A dreadful scene greets her as she sees her lover hanging by the neck. Subsequently, due to the trauma, she sees a psychiatrist. She breaks down, blaming herself for not recognizing the flags before his untimely demise. Later, Explode Hair and the others were trying to comfort Blonde through a group chat, when suddenly their deceased friend is spamming for help. Thinking that the programmer's computer has been hacked, they decide to meet up. Explode Hair volunteers to go to the programmer's place and log off his computer. Not too long, Explode Hair arrives at the apartment and begins to look around. He hears some strange noises, but ignores them and carries on. Then, a pale lady slowly emerges from the dark side of the room. Explode Hair stares at the paranormal entity, unable to move a muscle or a piece of his hair due to shock. As it slowly moves towards him, it somewhat glitches, fading in and out. But it continues to move forward. When his senses come back, he goes under the bed, hoping to escape it. But there's no escape from the ghostly entity, and like the programmer, it sucks the soul out of Explode Hair, but spares his smelly hair. After finding out that Explode Hair couldn't finish the task, Blonde figures that she has to take the matter into her own hands. She then visits the apartment, only to discover that the landlady has already sold the computer. She tracks down the buyer, Blue Eye, and confronts him. She lashes out at him for hacking into her dead lover's computer and sending inappropriate messages to their friends. But Blue Eye defends himself by showing her that he hasn't plugged in the computer yet. Blonde then leaves without any hints. Curious about the whole situation, Blue Eye sets up the computer and comes across weird videos of individuals killing themselves. It freaks him out, and he turns it off. After meeting up with Curly and Eyebrow, Blonde runs into Blue Eye. She then goes with Blue Eye, who offers to show her the things he found on the programmer's computer. She freaks out after seeing the different videos and storms out. Blonde later goes to see the psychiatrist once again, hoping to get peace of mind, or at least a clear explanation after all the tragedies and things she's witnessing. After hearing out Blonde, the psychiatrist stands her ground and tells her to face what is coming because it is the only logical thing to do. Blonde resumes attending her classes. The campus isn't as lively as before, and fewer people are showing up. Later, she enters a cubicle to relieve herself. She hears strange noises and investigates where it is coming from, only to run out scared after seeing someone peek through in what was supposed to be an empty cubicle. Eyebrow decides to visit his pal, Explode Hair. Upon arriving at Explode Hair's place, he sees a video of Explode Hair on the computer. Then Eyebrow sees Explode Hair stuck in the wall, crying for help. Still confused at the situation, Eyebrow reaches out for his friend as Explode Hair is being sucked into the wall. Inevitably, Explode Hair disappears and leaves a charcoal-like trace on the wall. Eyebrow goes back to his place and puts red tape at his windows and at the door. Eventually, he runs out of tape before he can cover the peephole and see something. He takes a closer look and sees a head that has only a large amount screaming. The glass from the peephole breaks towards his eyes. Back at the psychiatrist's office, a strange video of his daughter disturbs the mind of the doctor. After a while, he hears a strange noise in his office. He looks around and sees a glitching silhouette. On the same night, Blonde wakes up from weird noises on her computer. Strange videos play without her doing anything, and it terrifies her. She plugs her computer off in a panic. Suddenly, her printer goes to life and prints out unclear images. She arranges the pages like some sort of puzzle, and it reveals a face. Deep into the night, Blue Eye arrives and spots Blonde waiting by his place. Soon he shows Blonde a video diary of the programmer that he was able to retrieve from the damaged hard drive. Blonde reflects on the situation and theorizes that all the strange suicide and the virus are connected. Blue Eye dismisses the idea, for it doesn't sound logical. On the other hand, Curly is trying to get her laundry done. As she descends, she hears someone tapping her door, but pays no heed. In the laundry room, the door suddenly closes, and the power goes out for a while. All of a sudden, the washing machine's door opens. Wet clothes drop on the floor, as if someone is throwing them from the inside. She investigates what is causing this. However, she's having a hard time seeing due to the flickering light. Something is inside. Suddenly, an ungodly creature appears. She screams while taking a step back. It has four abnormally long legs and a pale complexion. The creature is like a spider coming out of its trap hole. It crawls towards her and sucks her life out in an instant. Back at Blue Eye's place, he is able to locate the hacker's address, and also, he discovers the USB that had the virus to end it all. After a series of events, Blonde witnesses her best friend, Curly, disintegrate into ash particles. She tries calling her mom, but isn't able to reach her. Then she calls up Blue Eye to come and pick her up. Not too long, Blue Eye arrives, and the duo rushes to the hacker's address and encounters a group of people along the way. There they discover that the safest place to stay is where there's less technology. Anywhere with no technology is a sanctuary. Therefore, the pair resumes seeking out the hacker. They reach the location and knock on the door. Blue Eye calls out to the hacker, but there is no answer. They force their way in and uncover a messy room full of red tape. They look around, trying to look for clues of his whereabouts. To their surprise, a man rushes to close the door they open, shouting that the unearthly creatures might get in. He closes the door and tapes it shut. The man appears to be the hacker, the man who started all this, and who the programmer was supposed to meet at the library. Blue Eye grabs the hacker by the collar and forces him to tell what this is all about. The hacker discloses that it was supposed to be a telecom project. He discovered frequencies he didn't even know existed, like a frequency to another dimension. He explains that they can travel through technology and through the shadows. Hence, the red tape can be used to hinder them from doing so, due to its capability of blocking part of the spectrum. He further explains that when a creature grabs hold of a person, it takes out the inclination and determination to live. It's like the lights are on, but no one is home. They get the information on where the server is located, attempting to upload the virus developed by the programmer to destroy the server, and thus terminate the mysterious entities. Later, they head out. As they enter the building, they are surrounded by paranormal entities. Blue Eye holds onto the door to keep them from following and orders Blonde to run to the elevator. She does what she's told and goes in. Blue Eye tries to catch up, but a silhouette of male twin stands in between them. He shouts to Blonde to go on sacrificing himself. The elevator door closes and heads down. All of a sudden, the power goes out and the elevator stops. So she forces her way out of the elevator and proceeds to run to the dark corridors until she reaches a door. She opens it and realizes that she has reached the server room. It emits a pulse-like aura and sound. She approaches the computer and sees a live feed of herself. She hears a whisper and looks back. A glitching silhouette then approaches her. A second later, the shape becomes apparent. It is a figure of a bald man gnarling at her. An image of her grabbed by thousands of hands shows as the bald phantom sucks her soul and life. Blue Eye then comes to the rescue and pulls her out of the room. Blue Eye bravely goes back to end this once and for all. Soon after, Blue Eye successfully uploads the virus, hoping that it will stop the supernatural carnage. He grabs Blonde and runs outside. As they move out of the building, they see hundreds of people on the rooftop building. Then, a plane crashes not far away. The scene is chaotic and apocalyptic. They get inside a car, and Blonde grabs Blue Eye's hand as they drive away. The duo are resting late in the evening, only to be woken up by the creature's attack. As they escape, the entities are trying to choke them out and crash the car. Fortunately, they reach a place with a low to no signal, and it saves them both. They soon arrive at a safe haven, a refugee camp set up by the government. This is Daniel CC Movie Channel. Stay safe and enjoy your day.